It's AumSum time!
Is rubbing your eyes good or bad? Good. No bad. Maybe both.
Oh, AumSum.
We usually rub our eyes due to lack of sleep, or to remove dust, irritants, etc. Now, sometimes rubbing our eyes for brief periods can be good because it activates the release of tears, which lubricate our eyes. Rubbing even stimulates the vagus nerve, which in turn slows down our heartbeat, helping relieve stress. However, don't make it a habit. Firstly, continuous rubbing can cause the outer layer of our eyes, called cornea, to get thin, weak, and conical in shape, causing a disease known as keratoconus, thus leading to distorted vision. Secondly, if there is an irritant and we try to remove it by rubbing, that irritant can end up scratching our cornea. Lastly, if people with glaucoma rub their eyes, it can lead to extra increase in fluid pressure, further damaging the optic nerve, eventually leading to blindness. Can sneezing make your eyes pop out?
No! It makes my snot pop out!
Ew, that's gross. Now listen. You might have heard your parents or friends telling that if you don't close your eyelids while sneezing, your eyes will pop out. However, eyes popping out, also scientifically known as globe luxation, is almost impossible. This is because your eye muscles and bony eye sockets are the ones which firmly hold your eyeballs in place every time, even while sneezing. Now, when you sneeze, a huge pressure builds up in your chest and head. However, this pressure is extremely unlikely to dislocate your eyeballs because the pressure is released through your nose and mouth. However, it is important to note that there are a very small number of cases reported in which eyeballs have indeed popped out due to sneezing. So, it's certainly not impossible, but is extremely rare. Do smartphones make our eyes worse?
No, they make food ordering fast and easy.
Oh, AumSum, listen. Among all light sources, a smartphone is the only one at which we stare for prolonged periods and hold it too close to our eyes. Hence, it puts strain on our eyes. Besides this, smartphone screens predominantly emit blue light. Now, our eyes are built to absorb the harmful ultraviolet rays coming from the sun, thus protecting the inner sensitive membrane called retina. But since they are not good at absorbing blue light emitted by smartphones, it hits the retina and produces toxic substances which slowly begin to damage the retina. Hence, long-term exposure to blue light may affect our vision. However, to resolve this issue, many manufacturers have incorporated a new feature called nightlight. Nightlight causes the screens to give off warmer colors, thus reducing the negative effects of blue light.
Why do your eyes turn red in the pool?
Ha! It is because of chlorine.
Chlorine is not the main reason for this. Chlorine is added to water of swimming pools because it is a disinfectant. It helps kill germs, thus keeping water germ-free. In fact, the main reason for our eyes to turn red is the presence of our bodily fluids like urine and sweat in the pool.
Ew!
Urine and sweat contain nitrogenous compounds like urea. Urea reacts with the chlorine present in water, forming chloramines. Now, if we regularly clean the swimming pool, then we can prevent the production of chloramines. But if the pools are not cleaned, then the chloramines formed can irritate our eyes, thus making them red. In addition to this, chloramines can evaporate from water. Inhaling these chloramines for a long period can result in coughing, asthma, and other health problems.